Hello, welcome to createwithsue.com. This is a video on creating applique with your ScanNCut and how you can do that using Embrilliance software. There are other ways of creating applique and I will cover that in later lessons. This one is focusing on the Embrilliance software and a little cheap way of getting it. So we'll go into Embrilliance. When I was looking for a software, my old software was PE Design and it did not export in SVG. So I purchased the most expensive ScanNCut that had the ability to read PES designs, but discovered later on that you didn't actually need this. So I have two ScanNCuts that read PES and one that does not. And that is the one I have been using for this tutorial. In general, so I'm doing a whole series of applique, and the one that does not read PES is the one I've been using. So if you have in the same boat as this, you'll find out lots about applique in this applique series. While I was on my journey, I tried to choose the best and most economical software, and what I came across was Embrilliance. And I found that there was a little demo version that you could test out before you bought it, which I thought was great. So I actually been playing with it still. I've purchased now three modules of it, but I still go into the demo and to see what the next module has added extras, so which ones I want to buy next. So it's a little bit addictive. I'll give you the heads up, a little bit addictive. Especially if you're a sewer. Anyway, this here is the icon for Embrilliance Demo on my screen. So we'll open that up and you can see it says demonstration version. So this version will not let you save. However, I'm pretty sure it lets you export SVG still. So you can check box whichever ones you want to, whichever modules you want to review. We're going to choose the Essentials, which is the very base model. So if you're just starting out with embroidery and just need a few things to help you get your designs with wording or adding text to something, easy things, Essentials is the way to go. So we'll just click the checkbox on Essentials and go okay, and it opens up to a screen that looks like this. And I have my hoop set for 4x4 because my one of my brother embroidery machines has only a 4x4 hoop. So I've been working with that for this tutorial, for this series I've been working with. You have all the normal icons up the top. You know, you open, you save, you print, you copy, you paste, you undo. They're all the normal ones. Has this one here, which I really love, called the Stitch Simulator. We'll have a look at that in a moment. It has some designs in it, has some text, and we will open one of my designs. If you have your purchased version, you will have a recent file also, so you'll see your recent design, so it's a little bit of a time saver. Does not do it in the demo though. We just go to open. And I'm in the cupcake design, which is one I've been working on for you. And we'll go into and bring the PES version in. I've got Brother Machine, so I work in PES. We'll bring the PES version in. And you can see it's popped right in the center of the 4x4 hoop. Over here on the right is the objects menu. And with this little cross here, if you click on that, drop that down, you will see all the components of this design. Just scroll down to the right and you can see all the components. So if I click on one of these, click this heart, you'll see that is activated and you can see the box around it. Gives you the option to move it around, re-angle it. Does on this version. This is my design that I've created. Some people may lock theirs down, I'm not sure. It gives you the various, there's the topper, there's the wrapper. Right at the top here I have the cupcake wrapper position stitch. So that's the stitch that runs along on your machine and then you iron your applique onto. So we'll click on that and you can just see the outline of the position stitch going around there. If we go into the stitch simulator, bring that up, and we'll just click on go. You can speed this up or slow it down. I might slow it down for this because I actually only want the position stitches to show on this one. And you'll see it stitch a position stitch, which is a place, can be known as a placement stitch. And there is the topper. So to get your applique design, you need to click on the ones that you work out are position stitches. If you can't see, I can't actually see that that's the position stitch from that at all on the right hand side there. So if you're in that same boat and you can't really work it out, using the stitch simulator will help you find the position stitch. And we'll click on the position stitch. Down in the bottom here, you'll notice that it brings up a thread color. And if you double click that, it brings up a box that has color, where you can change the color. So Essentials will let you change your color threads and that, which you don't actually need to because you just put your color thread that you want in. I often change my mind halfway through my design and think, oh no, I actually like this color better than that color. So, but it does give you the opportunity to change it. You click on the second tab, which says applique, and that's the one we're looking for. So at the moment it says not applique. So what we want to do is drop that down and choose applique position. And in the essentials, it will open up a screen that looks like this. So it's a little drop down or an additional component to the screen. And it gives you some options here, fabric view, whether you see what the some fabric looks like in there, or none or clear. I usually just leave it on none. I don't play with that too much, but you certainly can if you need to look what your design's going to look like. It also gives you the option to inflate. Now, this is a really handy area. Someone suggested that the best selection was to inflate by 1.5 millimeters. I didn't find that was the case at all. So when I was playing with it, I went, oh no, that's too much. So anything under 1.5 you'll find will work, but I like 0.5. Let's put a little zero in there for my keyboard. So 0.5 I found works really well for me. And it's sort of the one that you could have it bigger, but it sits pretty much right on that position line, just covering it. So you can have it bigger if you choose, but that's the one I've liked. And go save. And it will bring up the option to save it. So you can see that I have already saved this one, and I saved it without the 0.5 and tested that. It wasn't that great. I saved it with 1.5 and it wasn't that great either. And I've also saved at 0.5 and that was the one that was like good. I like that one. So find the place where you want it to save. So you locate, you can move up and down, up one level, down one, create a new folder, whatever you need to in here. Just works normal operating system type settings. And give this a name. So I'm not going to save over my design, but I would name it a name that makes sense to you, whatever name it is, and add SVG on the bottom. So type SVG, and you can see it's a scalable vector graphic file, SVG, and go save. So I'm just going to change this a little bit because I don't really want to muck up my original file here, and go save. Now this next screen is a fairly important one. If you are using a Cricut, you would change the DPI, but for a ScanNCut, the 96 DPI is the one you want. I don't know whether you noticed when you have designs come in from various designers onto your ScanNCut or into Canvas Workspace, and they come in very small. That is because the designer is potentially a Cricut designer and they use the 72 DPI as the default. And DPI is just dots per inch, which is technically a printer term, but they've used it in this. And makes sense because Brother's a printer company. So DPI it is. So 96 DPI is the one you need to go for, and then you click OK. And it will save to wherever you've chosen to save it. And then I'll just get cancel out of that because I don't actually need to save that. And then if you go OK, this will actually rename this as a position stitch. So I'm going to go OK. And you can see applique position stitch over here on the right in the objects. So the next one we have two pieces of material in this design. It's a fairly simple design, so it's a good one to start with if you're not used to applique. And then you do the exact same thing. So that's, if there's multiple pieces, you just keep doing it until you've got all the pieces. So once again, you double click the click on the color chart in the properties, so you'll just see there's only one there. There's lots of colors in the design, but we've highlighted just the cake topper or the icing. It's the icing, I guess. And click on that, and same deal, applique, it's non-applique, go position stitch, it pops down the box. Actually remembers your last setting, so you don't have to keep setting that. When you get additional modules of Embrilliance, there are some more areas down here. See, the space is blank, quite a big box for those blanks. More choices are added as you build your software. And once again, you can go save, and it's just the same. Save it with a 0.5 or a SVG and a name. I'll just get SVG on the end on that. So SVG, you don't have to put that there. I like SVG. You'll see I've named quite a few with SVG on them. It's a really quick way of working out that that's your SVG file. Your software will tell you, your operating system will tell you, but this is the very easy way to work it out. And go save once again, and it will pop up the box. 96 and go OK. Then you send it over to your machine. So this is really just a tutorial on Embrilliance on doing this. I will include it in the start of my tutorials on cutting the applique files, the designs. So if you watch the whole series, you can skip past those if you don't need to watch them all the time, although I may tell you something new. I don't know. We'll soon find out. All right. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this first intro session, and let's look forward to making some more applique designs with our ScanNCut and our embroidery machines. I'll catch you in the next video. See ya.